Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain Huffman Coding Algorithm, and I'll be solving one problem based on Huffman Coding. But before that, let us see the basic steps which is there with Huffman Coding Algorithm. So first, the source symbols are arranged in order of descending probability. So that is what we need to do first, and then the two of the lowest probability should be assigned with bit 0 and bit 1. And then combine last two symbols and move the combination symbol as high as possible. The repeat above step till end. And then write down code of that. And based on that code, we should do this calculation where efficiency should be calculated as per H divided by L log of base 2 R, where R that is based on which kind of system that we are using. If binary is there, in that case, for binary, R will be 2 and symbols will be 0 and 1. For ternary, R will be 3 and symbols will be 0, 1 and 2. For quaternary, R is equals to 4 and symbols will be 0, 1, 2 and 3. In this session, I'll be solving question based on binary. In next session, I'll solve example based on ternary and quaternary. So R is equals to 2 for binary system, for ternary it is 3 and for quaternary it is 4. And here L is average length code, that is summation of PI NI, and H is entropy, that is summation of PI log of 1 by PI base 2. And here variance, that is summation of PI into NI minus L, where L is average code length, square of that. So these are the basic formulas. You just note down these formulas. That is what we are dealing with to utilize in this example. So step by step, let us calculate this example so it will be more clear. So see, here in question, alphabets with probability 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.1 and 0.1 for symbols S1 to S5 is given. So first we will be write down, we will calculate Huffman code. So for Huffman code, first we need to arrange this probability in descending order. So here there is symbol and here there is probability. Now it is already in descending order. So let us write down S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5. And probabilities are 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.1, and 0.1. Now next step is add last two probability and move it to as high as possible. So we are adding this two. This is assigned with 0. This is assigned with 1. And moving it to as high as possible. So we will be moving it up to this. The reason is here there is 0.4. So now we will be finding here there is 0.4. Addition of this 2, 0.1 and 0.1, so that is 0.2. This 0.2 will shift here, and this 0.2 that will shift here. Now again, add this last 2 probability and move it to as high as possible. So 0.2 plus 0.2, 0.4, so it will be moving to the top. The reason is this is even 0.4, but we need to move it to as high as possible, so it will go up to maximum. Here there will be 0, here there will be 1, this will go to maximum 0.4. Now this 0.4 that will move here, and this 0.2 that will move here. Now if you add this 2, this with 0 assign, this assigned with 1, and addition of this 2, that is 0.6, so it will move here, and this 0.4 that will move here. And now there are two bits only, so assign this with bit 0 and assign this bit with 1. So that is how we should solve Huffman code. Add last two, move it to as high as possible and rearrange that and repeat that till you have assigned last bits. Now it is little tricky to write down code word and code word length. So let us write down code word. So I'm just mentioning data symbol, that is S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5. Code word and here length. So this many data that we need first. Now for S1, see here we are moving like this. S4, S4, then 0, then it is moving like this 0. So from this direction we should take bits, so 0, 0. So code word is 0, 0. Now for S2, we are moving by this path. So for S2, we are moving by this path. So this is going from here. Then it will go top. So from this direction, we should consider code. So 1 and then 0. Now for S3, we are going from this path. So it will be 1 now. So 1, 1. So that will be the code. Now for S4, we are going by this path. So 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0. For S5, zero, one, zero, one, one, zero, one, one. That is how we can write down code. So you just go in this direction, but code should be written in this direction. That is how we should write. I hope you have understood this. You just practice it and check it with my example so that it will be more clear. Now write down length. So length of this is 2, is having 2, is having 2, is having 3, and is having 3. So now here this is binary. So for this, first we need to calculate entropy. So let us have entropy first. So entropy H is equals to summation pi log of base 2 1 by pi. So that is 0.4 log of base 2 1 divided by 0.4. This is 2 times. So 2 times of 0.2 log of base 2 1 divided by 0.2 plus this is even 2 times. 0.1 is there 2 times. So 2 into 0.1 log of base 2 1 divided by 0.1. So if you do this calculation, I have already done it. So you just note down it and just check it out in calculator whether it is correct or not. So that is 2.12 16 bits per symbol. Now let us calculate code word length, average code word length, L. So secondly, we'll be calculating L, that is summation of pi ni. So that is 2 into 0.4 plus 2 into 0.2 plus 2 into 0.2. So 2 into 0.4 plus 2 times 2 into 0.2. 2 into 0.4 plus 2 times 2 into 0.2. Then 3 into 0.1 plus 3 into 0.1. So that is even 2 times, is 3 into 0.1. So 3 into 0.1, 2 times. So if you calculate this, you'll be finding it is 2.2 bits per symbol. Now we have entropy as well as average length, so we can calculate efficiency. Efficiency is H divided by L into, I have already shown you formula initially, log of base 2 R. Now here H we have calculated, L we have calculated, and for binary R is 2. So H is 2.12616, L is 2.2, R is 2, so log of 2 base 2, so this is 1. So if you calculate efficiency, so this efficiency, that is 96.4. I have calculated this. Now variance, so I have already shown you formula initially. Variance, that is sigma square, that will be summation of pi ni minus l whole square. So that is pi, so probability of first code, that is 0.4, ni, so ni, that is this 2. So 2 minus 2.2 square plus s2, that is 2, and that is happening 2 times with probability 0.2. So I'll write down 2 times probability 0.2 into 2 minus 2.2 square plus s3, that is 3, with equal probability 0.1. So 2 times 0.1 into 3 minus 2.2 whole square. And if you do this calculation, I have done that, you'll be finding it is somewhat 0.16. And this variance, that should be as low as possible. So that gives you idea like you have best code or not. So if variance is less, you can say it is very good code. So let us have a quick review again. First, we need to arrange symbols with respect to probability in descending order. Then take last two symbols, assign 0 and 1, and move it to as high as possible in descending order. So 0.1 plus 0.1, 0.2, it is coming here. And rearrange that. Again, add last two, assign 0 and 1, move it to as high as possible. Last two, add, move it to as high as possible, assign bit 0 and 1. Then go in forward direction first and take bits in reverse direction. So see, S1 is going like this. So bits are 0, 0. S2 is going like this. So bits are 1, 0. S3 is going like this. So bits are 1, 1. S4 is going like this. So bits are 0, 1, 0. S5 is going like this. So bits are 0, 1, 1. That is how we can identify code word and length. Once you identify code word and length, we just need to place that into basic formulas. First is entropy, that is H is equals to summation pi log of 1 by pi base 2. Second is code word length, that is summation of pi ni. Efficiency is H divided by L log of R base 2, where R is based on which kind of code that we are using. If it is binary, it is 2. For ternary, it is 3. For quaternary, it is 4. That is how we can have R. I'll explain example based on trinary as well as quaternary in next session. And then variance, that is summation pi into ni minus l whole square. and that that variance should be as low as possible. So this is how we can solve this example. You write down your suggestions as well as answers in comments. Definitely I'll try to get back to you and I'll try to solve out all those problems which is there with you. Thank you so much for watching this video.